All right, got a perfect morning. Gonna rig up here, switch from throwing some soft plastics and use some live bait today. Do something a little bit different. Show you how I like to rig up mud minnows. See if we can't pull some flounder and redfish off of this flat here. Even though flounder season's closed, probably still gonna pick up some while we're targeting drum. We got plenty of bait working. It's killing me not throwing topwater this morning. But we'll get some. She's using a slip bobber here. All right, so this is how I like to rig mud minnows. Using maybe an 18-inch leader out here. And this is 20-pound Momoy fluorocarbon to a 2-watt Mutu light circle. Barrel swivel to a slip float. This way I can adjust the depth. This 20-pound fluoro is really more to guard against flounder, their teeth. And I'm using a circle because I'm going to be floating this through a couple different creek channels. And what I don't want is to gut hook any fish, especially flounder, with it being a closed season. So I'm just going to rig up my mud minnow. I'm going to head over to a bank that's been fairly good to me in the past couple years and go drift some mud minnows. I just like to take mine and rig them just through the lips, just right up through and out. Just being careful not to rip the mouth open. I'm actually gonna stay off a little bit because I know that there's some oyster bars. And I don't want him to get hung up in any of those oyster bars. Nice slop fish. Didn't even notice that guy. This guy doesn't even know he's hooked yet. There we go. There we go. Come on, buddy. Come on, buddy. Stay up. Come on. Again, right in the corner of the mouth, right where it should be. Excellent slot limit. Perfect eating size. We got tacos. Another nice slot limit redfish here. Live bait, beautiful fish. Get some water flow in here. Pick up some more fish. Can't believe we haven't picked up a flounder yet. Just real surprised. They are usually in here chasing all these bait fish that we're seeing. I'm not real deep. These flounder, we pick them up in gold spoons in here, so we know they're in that upper water column when they want to feed. Just kind of surprised we haven't picked up one this morning yet. Oh, there we go. There we go. Thank you. Stay out of that other line. Oh, crap. Got one up front too. Right in the corner. Every time. That feels like a flounder. Yep. That's what I thought. Totally missed him. That's a decent fish right there. Yeah, not as big as I thought, but he's got some fight. Out of the pedals. He wants out of here. Come on, get in there. Another beautiful redfish there. Great, great fish. Nice red, pretty colors. Love that blue tail on there. tell you what, this is slim pickings in here. Red. Nice red. Couple spots. I had somebody ask me about my bait well here. This is the Bait Shark 4-quart. Thing is perfect for kayakers. It floats on its side, streamlined, got a little keel underneath. No need to take it out when you go from spot to spot. It's perfect, doesn't act like a big brick like some of the other ones do. It's 3D printed, pretty cool. I know they make a bigger one, a 5 or 5.5 quart, but links down in the bio. Highly recommend picking up one if you kayak fish with live bait. Beautiful fish. Check out the spots on this fish. Beautiful. It's the other side as well. Let's get him back in. Beautiful looking tacos swimming away right there. Just as I was trying to get my other line in the water.